Hi guys, welcome back to Geisha Gaming! So, this is another legendary rank match where I play as psychologist. I'm not the Geisha. And for everyone that's new to my YouTube channel, hello! And maybe some of you still thinking that I am a pro Geisha player, I'm sorry that you are wrong. I mean, like, Geisha Gaming is my name. I explained it already on that video, so you can click the suggested link if you want to know more or you haven't watched that video yet. So I actually stopped playing as Geisha after the butterfly adjustment. The frame drop is so bad for my phone. I've been playing this game since season 1 2018, and yep, in the beginning I also played Geisha. Me and my team was top 50 on the first choa, but well, two players are busy with school and work, so we cannot collect more points to get to higher tier competition on the choa. But then, to be honest, I started to enjoy more playing Survivor because I got bored so fast playing alone as Hunter, and to be honest, I got bored on playing any game so fast, and Identity 5 is the one that I played so long. I mean, like, how long have you guys been playing this game though? I've been playing more than 3 years in total. So I made many tips actually since 2018 and share it through my YouTube and also through my Instagram. On this video, I'm gonna share one of the most OP trick that I shared actually before years ago. But there is a certain timing that you need to know. I'm gonna remind you one more time about this. Okay, so I was trying to give another pallet stun to that Geisha though, but the pallet stun hand button is kinda delayed, or maybe just another bad timing, but in total it's supposed to be 2.5 cyber stun. I mean, like, explore still digging, right? So anyway, I know huge difference between playing with PC and mobile. You can have better control and wider view on PC, but you also need a good PC. I mean, if your phone is a potato and your computer or laptop is a potato, then it is the same frame drop issue, guys. It's the same thing. This game is heavy, I know that. So mercenary is coming for the rescue. I was thinking, like, be careful with the double hit from above, be careful with that. But the double hit is kind of failed, but remember, for fresh rescue with Titaner, no need body block is okay. Especially when you only have one rescuer, so they can go again for the second one. My bad though over there, I looked behind to dodge the 360, but well, I got stuck into the barrel. I got hit again, this is not good. But anyway, by watching this safe replay, I just noticed that Geisha actually bring up normal on this match, you know, to countering the Cypher rush, but I didn't kite to near the Cypher that has progress, or I didn't get down on the Cypher that has a lot of progress. So the Cypher was still fine. As you can see here, Knife still waiting for the second rescue. We need to be patient because after this I'm gonna die, and the Cypher left still 2 on progress. I mean, like, the last 2 Cypher we gonna pop I think around the same time. So I was telling Bluebird, try to cover me, try to receive another hit, or let's say just force heal me, because the Cypher, I think we can make it on time, like around 91% and 82%. So if you're playing a standard character, you also can assist with your team. Yep, as you can see, we can make it on time, guys. I mean, like, that's the tips. We did it since years ago, but please do it when the Cypher is about to prime. I mean, like, don't do it when the Cypher is still 70%. Okay, so Hunter changed the teleport and taking down the explorer that's still opening that exit gate. I was heading to the other exit gate near the cornfield, and then Knife standby to help explorer. Super be careful and look around, you guys. I mean, like, you need to crawling and losing the blood trail. Remember that I only play with Knife. Good thing is explorer bring distress persona, so we can see each other location on this stage. I mean, I always mention it to everyone too on my video, bring distress persona if you're playing solo or playing with random players. Nice, after rescue the gate has been opened too, and I also opening the other exit gate that's about to get open. Okay, so the dungeon is over here below the ship, and Knife and also Postman still waiting. So after I left, let me show you, this is my live record there. I mean, like, I use the lowest graphic as you can see here. So both of them are near the dungeon. I mean, like, waiting for the tension to be over. Two gates have been opened, so this is not a good situation for the Hunter at all. Yep, finally Hunter surrendered. The patient is already over. So that's the tips, guys. I hope it will be helpful for you. Don't forget that do this force heal trick only when Cypher is about to prime. Thanks for watching, and I see you again on my next video. Bye bye.